Okay, our next posture is boat pose. And this is a prone boat pose, meaning you're on your belly, as opposed to the one that you might have seen in other fitness classes where you're seated, and they're all equally valid. This is a great entry posture for back bending and getting you strong in your core. I'm going to follow it with child's pose, and then we'll again we're going to do a teaching demo after the silent demo. Here we go. Boat pose, Navasana. So props can be used for this as well. Any of the back bends from the belly, you are able to use a blanket under your hips, especially if you tend to be kind of bony here. And also it does create just a little ease in your back. So whichever feels right, and you can make it as thick or as narrow as you'd like. So I'll demonstrate how you could vary this first, and then I'm going to show you, I'm going to do the demos for the boat pose and give you some variations, and I'll do the variations for child's pose. So again, the blanket can be under your hips, hands along the side of the body, feel the energy of your feet, drop them down, and you can move into this posture by just simply lifting your trunk. And maybe that's your first stage where you need to stay and just breathe. And maybe just lift the legs. And you want to keep yourself breathing. And maybe just keep your hand on that. And you could also let that go. You could also do it more challenging where you lift it all. On the inhale, and let your body exhale. And then you inhale and lift. And you exhale. And even more challenging would be to come into the pose and lift, and then maybe take the arms overhead. But if you stop breathing, your body's kind of told you kind of not to do that. And in terms of Ayurveda, dear Sharon tells us that if the arms overhead is beneficial for prostate health for men, and arms staying back by the hips is beneficial for women's ovaries, etc., and the reproductive system. So, child's pose, if you have knee issues or any tightnesses, you can take and put a blanket there. You can put a block so that it's right up under the groin, right at the pelvis, so that it's giving your pelvis a little bit of ease, so it's lifting you so you're not pressing into your knee joints, all right? And you can also add it all. And some people like to take their knees out wide, and you can put a blanket under there. Again, it's all meant to get a little lift in the knee joint, so you're not pressing down that knee joint. This is beneficial if you're bigger in the belly, if you're pregnant, also very good. And you can go down. You could put a block here to let your head be in. Your arms can be forward. I like to have my knees in because I'm missing a meniscus on the inside of my right knee. So it's really sometimes challenging to be there with the legs out wide. If your heels easily touch at the groin, the hips and the heels touch, you can have those knees wide, you can bring them on down. And then you just let yourself kind of melt into it. So let your shoulders relax. And you're on the third arm. And so you're right here if you want to. Again, so child's pose. If this is uncomfortable to your knees, there's no need to suffer at all in yoga. Yoga isn't about suffering. So maybe you just roll over, and there you go. That's your child's pose. You just hug yourself in and just love on yourself. So those words, boat pose and child's pose. Just paying attention to how I got up. Okay, I rolled myself over and I pressed myself up.